And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Yeah. All this blah, blah, blah conversation we're having in the studio. We have a radio. The people are waiting for us, everyone. It's The Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. We are live on Mandatory Metallica Monday. I'm Big J. Oakerson. That's Dan Soder. We are down one Andy Fiore.
I know. It's Jacob's sitting in. It seems weird.
Jacob's on phone screen right now, which I know he feels like is a real emotional demotion.
Yeah. Emotional demotion.
What That's got to be a Corey Feldman song.
That has to be.
Emotional demotion. Pink slip of feelings.
Lou Dog's here, though.
Everyone's here.
Fuck yeah.
Besides Andy.
Consistent.
And we unveil our newest member. I like when they do that in wrestling.
Oh, yeah.
The Four Horsemen got a new member coming in, and you'll find out who that is. We took Andy and we made him better.
It's, he's gonna be in about 45 minutes, our new phone screener, right?
Yeah, there's a clue.
He's running late. Yeah, there's a clue. He's running 45 minutes late, so we'll let you take a guess.
His best friend is a black guy.
There you go, Lou. Thank you.
You had the greatest seats I've ever seen for a concert yesterday.
It was.
I mean, I like.
Bonkers.
It's fucking, you did it subtly to the point where I was like, you know when someone ramps up something and, uh-huh. And they're like, dude, I did this and it was this and this and this, and you're like jealous, and then they're like, you want to see a picture? And you're like, yeah, cool. I'll look at a picture. But what Jay did was he did it on the slide where he goes, hey, look at this. And he's like playing a video, and I'm like, that's James Hetfield 3 feet away from me.
3 feet away from me.
3 feet away from me. And not in a bullshit. In an actual 3 feet away.
If I had reached my hand out, they would have like, they were high-fiving everybody.
You had an MTV camera view of like when they do a fucking...
Nuts.
That's insane.
And I broke it to you like that because... But here's the thing, Dan. As a guy whose comedy, you know, topic, my pool of funny,
yeah,
is always rooted in dick pussy or somehow jizz,
yeah, well, you're the
I have to learn the act of subtlety in delivery.
Yes. You are a master.
You can see right now my hand motion.
Yeah,
of sliding in the subtlety.
Also, the way you're saying it's like the way that a guy that teaches women self defense, where he goes,
"You got to turn the hips into it. You turn the hips,
and again, you say no. You say no means no.
I'm not a victim.
Yeah, man, it exploded inside of me. I was like, oh my god, you are 3 feet away from Metallica.
Crazy.
It was. I mean, the greatest seats I've ever seen in my life.
It was
legitimately the greatest.
It's called the Snake Pit. So they had a stage.
Snake Pit.
And then they had like a ramp that went out like a complete U off the stage. And the section inside that U.
Let me
called the Snake Pit.
Quick question.
Uh-huh.
Rich people or actual fans? Which one was it?
Fans.
Awesome.
I mean some real low-life garbage in that
yes.
thing. Yeah.
I always hate when you get that close and you realize
Eddie Trunk was right next to me, though. He brought his son, his wife.
All right, well, I'm not bullies with Eddie Trunk.
I was bullshittings with him.
That's awesome, man.
Craig Guest, their little precursor.
Next Wednesday.
He's coming the next Wednesday to describe the story. And something happened last night that's actually kind of funny. Based off that, we're coming in to kind of recap the story I told on Opie.
Yeah.
That I've told on here before.
Yeah,
thing, I believe,
yeah. I thought you, I swear and to God, Carla, I thought you
yeah,
told
maybe.
The story with Craig.
Carla's going to come in also.
Oh, all right, yeah.
She's going to, that was your idea, which I think is a great one.
Yeah, because she's there to balance it all out, but she's there to, she's like a witness, a non-comic witness.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
She's not going to make it, like, she's funny just by nature, but I'm saying, like, she's not going to, like, go for a punchline where you're like, no, that actually.
Don't tell Carla she's a non-comic.
Oh, no, she's
don't
a comic. I apologize. I forgot she's a comic now.
I don't know what's happening, but I'm a little distracted out of my peripheral. I think there's a Mexican doo-wop band playing
I don't
through
know.
A glass over
it
there.
Looks like the head of a cartel. That's all it looks like.
All you guys that's all we get to see tomorrow. But tomorrow's gone away.
I cut off his
it's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. Is there gotta be Christine right now? I need you to look up if there's a Cholo choir anywhere.
Oh, please find
Cholo doo wop, Cholo a cappella group.
Yip, 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 yip.
Sha-da-da-na, sha-na-na-na-na. Get a job.
When I worked
get a job.
When I worked in Tucson, there was a station called La Caliente. that was in the same building as us, and those guys had so much more fun at their radio station than anyone else. More so than the classic rock, who's like, yeah, we're getting the lead out. And then KFMA, which was like, you know, all stoner rock music. And then, dude, they would crack their heavy-ass doors and just be like, oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah. They're just going fucking nuts. They had the best time ever.
Did you guys shut them out, though, of KFMA Day?
Bro, if they wanted to go to KFMA Day, they could totally go to KFMA Day.
And I remember I was there at KFMA Day, and Blink-182 came out, and they played
a
song.
They weren't there. It was Offspring.
And then on KFMA Day, I remember.
And then my mom said I could go. I saw Metallica at KFMA Day, which is actually true. I didn't see him at KFMA Day, and I was right on the side of the stage, but your seats were better.
And then after KFMA Day happened, I remember The Used came out, and Bert McCracken is a god. And
actually, I was in a... I think The Used was there. They did a fall ball.
Of course they did.
With AFI.
He looks so...
Oh, Christine naturally geeked out. She's a closet AFI fan. But he looked what?
I'm trying to remember which person I was talking about. I got eight people in my head now. Yeah, The Used. The lead singer is so unlikable looking.
Bring him up.
He's a put on the song The Taste of Ink. Put that video
Oh God,
up.
We played that song a lot of
course.
KFMA.
4 o'clock in the fucking morning. I love it. That's the only song by them I like.
Did I tell you about, I've said this on the show about when we used to do our fake emo band at Dos Caminos when I was waiting tables. Did I tell you guys about that? Suburban Tragedy?
No.
We come up with fake emo songs. We go, I'm standing and I'm waiting and I'm right there now.
I did that on Skanks one time. It's like all the songs. Somebody goes,
remember that time you hurt my sweater?
Yeah.
I love that sweater. That was my favorite sweater.
Yeah, I swore I thought I talked about Suburban Tragedy on here before.
No. And I'm standing.
Oh, wow.
Right.
He looks bad.
Yeah. Wow. Is that now?
Yeah. He's all
fucking
sick.
That's 2013.
Though. Oh, boy.
Wow, he does not look good.
It does not age well.
What do you think Kelly Osbourne gave him?
Did you put it in him?
Go to the video.
Oh, wow. What a difference.
Go to the video for Taste of Ink. Just the way you say everything about I like this song, too.
Yeah, but the lead singer of, we're looking up the lead singer of The Used.
Bert McCracken.
Bert McCracken, who dated Kelly Osbourne and who ages like a banana.
There you go. Put on the video.
Well, hang on. I have what I thought was a Mexican doo-wop band playing in the background.
Oh, it's not?
No.
Who are these dangerous men?
For the longest time.
What if we looked over and they just put Deb's head on the counter? And they go, the cartel owns the Golf Channel now.
I still wanted to be up for that. Still doo-wop, though. Yeah,
but they like doo-wop. And then they're wearing an orange jacket. Men, no more. Benjamin, no longer.
It's
leader.
A revolution.
Yeah.
That's all the caddies coming back to take back their studio.
Yeah. We saw cocaínas down in Mexico.
Cocaine.
The Golf Channel now belongs to us. Deborah.
And if I ever fall in love again.
It's weird because we have The Used going on, but then we also have...
Mexican doo-wop. How unlikable does this kid look?
He looks like a guy that starts a fight in a bar.
He's got a real jerk-off face.
He goes, live in there! I promise I will take you there! Are those your shoes? Where do you buy your shoes? Pay less?
You're like, I'm gonna fight that guy.
Hey, look, everybody! Dan doesn't know how to zip his jeans! And they're open!
These poor guys, those emo rockers can't find a girl that weighs less than them.
Dude. Yeah,
it's impossible. It's you're always fucking a fat chick to your to you.
It's yeah. It's gonna be a heavier woman. You have to fight up.
You're always fucking a fat chick to your to you.
It's yeah. It's gonna be a heavier woman. You have to fight up.
I mean, I mean, this guy was dating Kelly Osbourne. He looks like a Kelly Osbourne like midnight snack decision.
Kelly, I'm worried you're gonna crush him.
I'm getting this human gummy bear.
I'm not this guy because he's too tiny. I want to eat him. Hey, Kelly. You look delicious. Kelly, you're huge.
Yeah.
Kelly, can we go to a movie tonight? Can I please have a bite I'm very hungry. I weigh 86 pounds. I appreciate rom-coms.
And then he aged like a... I mean, now he looks... He looks like True Detective Season 1.
Yeah, he's all grizzed out, huh?
Time's a flat circle.
He looks like Woody Harrelson in Out of the Furnace.
Yeah, yeah.
Like he's an inbred New Jersey Mountains bare-knuckle boxer.
Appalachian bare-knuckle boxer. They're, I mean, music is one of those things where you do not age well. It's like football and music.
Not if you do it right.
Yeah, well, then you get all Botoxed up. Suburban Tragedy's a real, oh god damn it, it's a real band?
I don't think it's a real band because this video only has like 3,300 views on it.
I mean, it's a,
that's
I mean,
a pretty, what yeah. do you mean?
Well, I just want to let you guys know that My Suburban Tragedy was started in 2009 at Dos Caminos on a lunch shift with myself and Sam Podell. So there you go.
There's no Uber in my town.
I go,
I'm standing and I'm waiting and I'm right here. What? Sam?
Take orders like that?
Regular guacamole. My girlfriend.
Salsa.
She cheated and she took my hat.
That was my favorite hat. I mean, and people, when this was happening, this was like, this isn't popular anymore, right? I mean, we're not. No.
Emo?
Yeah. But it's like more like.
It's absolutely still popular.
It's still popular?
Of course.
There'll always be a need for emo.
But there was a time when emo was like almost like the EDM. It was like everybody listened to emo rock.
Not this
that
guy.
Was the, it was a thing. Well, you were older then. They're like the high what the high schoolers were into was, you know.
You were older, you
emo.
Geese. You got gray hair. Don't attack me.
This guy, he got personal quick, huh?
Because this broad.
This one's getting all yammy about who is old and what's not. Jimmy Eat World came out right when I graduated high school.
Are they emo?
Yeah.
I feel like Jimmy Eat World was almost before emo. It was like just when emo was starting up.
I'm too old for emo and I'm 33.
I feel like I'm a little too old for emo, but some of it hit me at the end.
I'm way too old.
I was sweeping the other night.
Oh, emo Phillips?
Alone.
Lou, you trickster.
The ultimate emo.
I'm definitely too old for EDM.
Yeah.
Is it okay, like...
I bet Lou likes it.
Lou, do you like any EDM?
No, I'm not on drugs.
See,
he likes it.
But does anyone
he is
over
on drugs,
30? Is there anyone over
like
30
it.
That likes EDM that isn't on drugs?
Lou, don't let Lou lie
not
to you.
Not on drugs. I don't think so.
On my life, Lou likes some EDM music. That, I know it.
Back when I was young and had hair, yeah,
there
I was way
go.
Into it.
Now see these excuses
yeah.
start coming up.
You should have been a lawyer.
There's still a couple that I mean, I guess I can listen to.
No,
Lou likes some EDM songs.
Look, they're all texting about us.
Mexican duo group, what do you think about it?
Say it easy and so, eat easy and so, whoa. Say it easy and so, whoa, 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 whoa.
I was waiting for it. I never, yeah, EDM, I think EDM's a young man's game.
It's
if there's
young,
anyone over 40.
It's a young woman and,
if you're
Molly salesman's game.
Yes, if you're over the age of 35 and you like EDM, call 844-266-3399. Just because it seems like a weird thing to be into when all these
I'd
young...
say call and tell us your favorite song, but you don't know.
Yeah, it's Blips and Bloops.
He goes, the second hour of Skrillex, Puxatawny, Pennsylvania,
the one
2016.
That's, the one that sounds like a truck's falling down a cliff of ice.
Let the beat drop.
I'm doing a joke about how I hate EDM on stage now, and people are reacting like there's a couple of people that are upset when I say it's the devil's music.
Well,
like,
yeah. off, bro.
There you go. First off, this is my favorite DJ. His name's Thwang. He's actually a trans Argentinian.
I'm matrixing while you're talking.
I know, bro. I see you feeling it.
Oh, God!
Truckers into yes. trance.
Oh, God.
Truckers into EDM.
Street trance.
He goes, man, I'm not going to lie. I'm jacked up on Molly, and I'm driving on this fucking... I'm an ass road trucker.
Could you... Again, to me, I always say music has to have some point.
Not just this?
No. But I'm saying there's got to be a point of a day, of a 24-hour day... Where you can be in a car and that music makes sense. And you can do that with almost every genre of music. You could find a time for country to make sense.
What about polka?
There's no time for... No, and polka's the other one. That's absolutely true. I said that very recently. I saw somebody with an accordion on the street by the cellar.
Yeah.
And I was like, what a bummer. I go, there's not... It's the only genre of music where there's nothing... There's no polka song I even sort of want to hear ever.
Ever.
There is an EDM song out there that I can hear and go, like, I like the way that sounds. Without a doubt.
Yeah.
Without a doubt.
Oh, this Eclipse. Do you remember when the Eclipse commercial? Yeah. Do you remember Chappelle did that? He goes... You know, it's Dirty Vegas. There goes Go By. It's one of the only songs that I like.
There's time in a car.
Chappelle did that sketch on season one of Chappelle Show. The no, 03 no,
there's
Eclipse.
There's absolutely not.
A 2003
time.
Mitsubishi Eclipse, a.k.a. Restaurant Manager Mobile.
The only time in a car when EDM would make sense would be to laugh at it with a buddy and do
and
that.
Dance like
and
an
dance
asshole.
Around like an idiot.
Yeah.
But the actual, like, where it's cool... Where there's a time where there's some dark country that can be cool in a car. Classic rock, no brainer. 80s music, absolutely.
Fun. 70s music.
70s
60s music.
Music. Yes. There is no place in a car ride for genuine driving around alone.
I wonder if there's someone who's just completely drained their serotonin levels on ecstasy and they're just punching the fucking steering wheel as we're saying this. They're like, EDM is great!
When I was like 21, there was this group of guys that were all like in their 30s that we hung out with, and they were strangely into like EDM, but it wasn't really called.
Wow,
like,
strange. They were into that and hanging out with girls 10 years younger than them.
Oh, wow.
I just called it all techno.
That's a surprise, Christine. Good call.
I'm going to take a wild guess. Not homeowners.
No, not homeowners, but one of them was like actually like a crazy scientist and had a good job. He just liked to do ecstasy and go to like EDM shows.
Oh, yeah.
So they're in their 40s
now. Let me guess, you probably hooked up with one of them or
whoa,
something.
Whoa, Jay.
Of course.
Jay, it's getting too personal now.
No,
Jay, I had sex before I met you. It's something you're going to have to deal with.
You sound like a boob even saying that. It had nothing to do with anything. She goes, it was so weird. There was these guys when they were 30 and they were all in the EDM. Goes, were they in EDM and also hanging out with girls 12 years younger than them and probably fucking one or two of them?
What was the science? He goes, fuck science.
He's a scientist.
He goes, I'm a scientist. I got to go move my beakers around. Christine and her 17-year-old
friend. I'd love to know exactly what that guy does. I promise you it is not science.
I don't really know exactly what he does, but
cook
something
meth?
Weird.
He probably goes, I was really top of my class, and then I decided I didn't want the medical field, so I just came out here and party.
I bet it's like sales equipment or something, medical equipment.
Look at this, dialed
back to maybe now. You're attacking.
I bet
what did I just do to Lou and Christine? I just lawyered them.
You were luring the shit out of him. But I bet his lab has a black light in it.
His what?
His lab.
His lab.
Is a scientist. He goes, it's just like a take me to your dealer poster.
Or one of those balls that has like all the lights coming off it.
He comes in, he's got a neon necklace around him and he's shirtless and he goes, I was just wrapping up an experiment. How awesome. Waves. Christine's raving with him in a science lab.
Hey, do you older guys like hanging out with 21-year-olds? Is it because we're so smart and cool?
Sean in Wisconsin, he says he used to like EDM music, but how do you get out of it? That means you never liked it. I've never got over a kind of music. I've always liked the songs I liked in it. Sean, you there, buddy? Hang on, Jacob's learning how to use phones.
Jacob is
the buttons are enormous to him.
Yeah. He's gonna have to jump around. It looks like a Lily Tomlin special.
Sean, you there, buddy?
I am. You guys hear me?
Yes, indeed, my friend. How's Cheesetown treating you?
It's doing good. Doing good. I just remember days where I'm the same age as Dan. 43? 33, correct.
Oh.
Yeah, and I still do listen to it once in a while. My daughters like dancing to it. But I just remember back in the days when it was like warehouse music, basement music, and it wasn't called EDM. It was called pretty much just
house.
Yeah, house,
trance, jungle. Dude, my friend's sister Megan got into it, and she like tried like straight face explaining it to me and my five friends.
Oh my God.
Who were like vultures.
It's like the music's colors.
She was in a van with us, and we fucking verbally beat the piss out of her for a good hour. Cause she goes, "No, it's fucking awesome, you guys." She was like 17, and we were 15, and she's like, "No, what happens is like there's like this awesome thing where this guy will like take a ball, and then he'll like dance with the ball, then the ball will get bigger," and we were like, boo! What? Are you really trying to explain that? You can't. It's goofy as shit. Just admit it's goofy.
It's just...
When did you get over
Sean,
it, Sean?
You're over, you say you still like some songs, though.
But when did you when did you stop regularly listening to it?
Probably after I got married and had kids.
That's great. You have your first kid and you're like, I gotta throw away this DJ Tsunami.
I just last time I sniffed angel dust off my wife's butt crack.
Yeah.
And then we had to hunker down, get some jobs.
She had angel wings and neon green lipstick as I BF'd her in a desert tent.
Oh, girls, your mom used to be a party.
She was a real handful. We used to go out to the Burning Man.
This is why me and Christine can never have kids. We can't go back and tell children the things we've done.
Well, you have also documented on the radio.
Yeah.
They can just listen.
Yeah.
They can listen to it like when you're like, you know when people used to be like, I found my grandpa and grandma's old love letters. Then they're like, I listened to the Bonfire and found out what my grandpa and grandma.
Yeah. Sean, real quick, what's your favorite EDM song? Do you have a favorite song?
I don't have a favorite song. I'm just surprised that, like, the Chainsmokers and all these people are, like, making Billboard money.
Oh, yeah, man. That's what happens. It goes underground, like, in the
90s. Is that EDM, though?
Kind of. It's EDM influenced.
Because there's lyrics and songs
they
are normal.
They turned it into pop music. I mean, that's what they always do. There's, like, in the 90s, the rave kids were actually dangerous. They're taking these, like, bags of pills.
What's the Chainsmoker song that I like?
I don't know.
Well, look it up.
Chainsmokers song J-Life.
No, look up Chainsmokers. I promise you.
I do like.
I'll know the name right away.
Jay, sometimes with Christine's video requests, you do ask her like you've been married for 70 years. Who's the boy?
This is very easy. This is very easy. Of all the time, let me give Christine. I got to break her down a little bit. This is how she learns.
Why? You're just upset about the scientists.
She looks up things in Google she should be looking up in YouTube and vice versa. She just YouTube Google, like, looks up things that doesn't make any sense to look up on YouTube.
I hate searching on the screen you guys can see. That's my first mistake.
Amen.
Search in YouTube Chainsmokers and it'll come up in the search thing.
Jay, is this any carryover from the sexy EDM scientist?
No. I know. I assumed one of these guys that she was talking about she hooked up with, but no, I was saying, okay. Keep going down. It's none of these. No.
Hey, Jay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hey, I know you guys kind of used to dabble or still dabble. But I remember kind of one of the worst mistakes, well, that I made several times. Was drinking cough syrup, a whole bottle, and just getting all jacked up.
Robo tripping. Yeah, dude. I mean, that was high school, but.
Dude, I'll tell you what, I met a guy who worked.
That shit's dangerous.
A guy who worked on Mayhem Fest with me told me he used to do that a lot, and I was like, wow, does that really work? He was like, oh, yeah, man, get you fucked up. Mm-hmm. And I go, and what, you just like, he goes, you stopped, you don't do it anymore? I was like, he's like, no, it fucked me up pretty bad. And then I go, really? He goes, yeah. I go, I still think I'm pretty fucked up from it, honestly. It was like years ago. Like, I remember that he was a very weird personality. He got a very good personality, but like, it was always like his eyes were always closed, and he would just smoke butts and never ash them. He's like, no. I go, you're totally fine from me. He goes, no, I think it really fucked me up like long term.
Yeah, fucked me up long term.
But maybe, well, because now what they do is now what's popular is drinking lean. That's cough syrup with codeine, mixed with Sprite.
Drink a lean.
No, it's called lean.
Oh.
Like sipping on lean, I believe. That's the widest way I consider it.
Drink a lean should be our fat loss shakes.
Drink a lean. Yeah. Do you like robo tripping? Do you want to lose weight?
We'll try drink a lean.
What we did is we put Stacker 3 fucking jacked up.
And one of those colon blowers that fucking you eat it and it shoots out.
Oh, dude. That's like when I found out that all those models on Instagram, when they do the fit tee, it just blows your asshole out.
Oh, wait. Turn this up. Here's my DM hit. Oh, dude. When this beat drops, dude, I want to see those body rolls. Don't let me down. Oh, we are sexy. Are these Mexicans looking? Where is our phone screener? He's dropping the kids back off to the park to his mom, to his ex-wife.
Dude, it's catchy as shit. These guys bug me the way they look like just two white guys that I used to babysit.
Yeah, absolutely.
You go, that's
what childhood?
You go, that's Derek and Mark. Those guys are chain smokers now. They're just in a hoopty.
Sean, thanks for the call.
I'm so good.
Hang up now in a second, but still there.
Yeah, no.
I just wanted to go down memory lane one more time to see if you guys have ever heard of taking same thing of over the counter chloroquine tablet, like a cold and cough.
No, is it good?
Yeah, it's about the same thing as Robo Trip.
Oh, yeah. Wait, so you can just take a pill and Robo Trip? All right.
Take like six of them. Or maybe
Got it. Disclaimer. Don't do that.
Yeah. Don't ever do that.
Don't ever take six pills.
Oh, man. Jacob's fucking Hitler over there on the fucking call screen. He just bagged up on him. Look, let this song keep playing. Shelby, North Carolina. 44 years old, four kids, loves EDM. Shelby, is this possibly true? Hang on while Jacob figures out how the phones work.
Yes, are you there?
Yep.
Shelby, you there, buddy?
Yeah, I'm here. Man, you guys rock, by the way.
Thanks, Shelby.
I love you. Yeah, seriously, I started listening to you guys about 3 months ago when you were talking about Corey Feldman and his crack wars. And then
That's not proven they're crack wars, but
they're crack age.
They are definitely runaways.
Jamie Foxx said they're crackish.
Yeah.
That's what he says.
You like EDM music, like legit straight face. You like put it in on the way to the grocery store, and you're 44 years old.
Yeah, I'm actually listening to what's called Chill right now on 53 on XM.
God damn it, Lou, bring that shit up. Chill, channel 53.
What I usually do is I'll smoke a bowl before I go to work and listen to when I go into work. And then throughout the day I'll have a little bit and listen to whatever I need to do.
Wait, so you listen to EDM to pump you up?
I just chill out before I go to work. Like, it depends on what you're listening to.
Smoke a little joint, and then go to...
smoke a little bit, yeah.
I'm guessing CEO of...
my friends call it Cape Bathhouse music sometimes, so that really busts my balls.
Now, four kids, do your kids now think the EDM is, like, lame? Because, dad likes it?
No, they're cool. I mean, they've got their own taste. My oldest is 25, and you know, she's kind of like that granola Colorado because that's where we're from. So she's kind of got that vibe.
I get it, bro.
So,
it's a weird thing when they talk about your kid. He goes, some granola, hairy armpit bitch, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, he was some real fucking, some mountain goat I call a daughter. But anyways, I'm from Colorado.
I mean, sharp bottoms of her feet cut your face.
Yeah.
I use EDM in my industry. So if you.
What's your industry?
I'm a professional.
You make glow sticks?
He goes, pacifiers. Children and adults. You're a fire dancer?
No, fuck that.
Oh, God.
I own the biggest ring pop distributor.
Kids. Yeah.
I wouldn't have four kids that have four boyfriends.
Oh, nice. But, wait, what do you... Oh, that
sucks. I'm a professional drone racing pilot. And in my industry, we use EDM in all of our videos that we make. And that's the only way to make them really kick ass.
Wait, so you fly drones professionally?
Yep, I fly around, race, compete, been on TV, been on ESPN, there's shows with us on it, yeah.
Do you notice, the drones react better to EDM than they do, say, a...
what's the pro drone circuits puss situation like?
Yeah,
is it just raining? Is it raining on you?
It's a bunch of swinging dick.
Oh, dude, that's so funny, though. If
not even like a fat Asian girl who wants to...
We get paid to travel the country. I mean, I went to a nine-day trip from San Francisco to Moab, Utah. All expenses paid. Traveled me all over to fly to all these locations that I would never go to or won't be able to go to again. It's a trip of a lifetime. And we get paid to do this shit, but we use EDM for like our videos that we have to produce, put on YouTube, and basically whore out our sponsors.
All right, so I think we found I think you're an outlier. I think if you're a professional drone pilot, you can like EDM at 44. Considering that's your music, like Iron Eagle, like do you put a tape deck?
Yeah, I feel like you should also.
You put a tape deck to your leg and then play EDM as you're flying?
I'm gonna Top Gun.
Who's your Lou Gossett Jr.? Who's the one that tells you to fly? He's like, damn it, you up there, you got something special when you fly them. When you fly them drones, your daddy would have been proud of you.
Now let that beat drop.
Now, boom.
You gotta check them out. You actually.
Yeah, we're watching it right now.
We're watching a video now from the Extreme Drone Circuit in Las Vegas.
Yeah, and we were on ESPN for a solid. I don't know. They repeat it all the time. It's Drone Racing League, DRL, and you can look up pilots like myself, Shelby, D-O-L-L. You go to my YouTube, that's exactly what you'll see.
Shelby. Now, you didn't make the mistake that a lot of professional droners will do and get married young before you see what's out there with your fame.
Exactly. Hey, Shelby, what's your last name?
The second word you look for is D as in Victor, O-L-L.
That's what I thought.
Hilarious. She put up Shelby Doll, and we got a naked picture of a woman.
Yeah, we're like,
there you go. That was back in my good old days.
Well, thanks for calling in, Shelby. I think you're an outlier. I think if you're a drone pilot, you don't count as liking, of course you like EDM. You like all things with robots.
Shelby, I'm not going to call you names. Outlier? That's Dan's thing.
You know what, bro?
Second, all right, dude.
I kind of read it the other day, and I like using it as much as possible. So I wish you'd use
it. Outliers. Outliers. Thanks for the call. I wanted to hear this one real quick before we take our first break. Will in Buffalo, black man who likes EDM? I bet I'd tell you what else he likes. 18-year-old girls who have glitter on their cheeks and wearing unicorn boots.
And I bet he fucks half-Asian women all the time.
Will, are we right on any of these?
I can't say that, no.
Okay.
None of those things are true?
No.
So you're, like, legit into EDM as, like, it's you would say it's your favorite music?
Yeah, pretty much right now.
All right.
And when you get in your car, you bump EDM?
Oh, yeah. Listening to BPM, Electric Area, and definitely you guys.
Electric Area. All right. So these are the stations on Sirius, Electric Area. What's your, because we're trying to guess names of songs. What's your favorite song right now?
There's a bunch of them, but one, I can give you two off the top of my head. Garmiani, Bomb and Drop.
Bomb and Drop?
Bomb a Drop.
Bomb a Drop.
Yeah. And then you got,
just brings up war videos on YouTube.
Maybe try separating a drop. Yeah, Jarmiani.
This is it?
Oh.
Nope, that's not it.
This isn't it?
This isn't it, Lou.
Lou, you Christine
found it.
Lou, you don't know shit about EDM.
Oh, real nice, DJ Lou. Where's your trap music knowledge?
Yeah. Why don't you keep it to Pearl Jam and keep it moving, Will? Not you, Will. I'm sorry. I meant Lou.
Yeah, Lou, I know you love this because it's like jam. It's like computer jamming.
Yeah, I don't like computers.
All right, so this is it. Lou, turn it up. This is Jermont.
Oh, it's the same thing. DJ Lou wins.
maybe he likes the...
This is too
Will, are you Will, are you into the remix?
I haven't heard the remix, but actually, I'm into, like, a lot of it. All the house stuff, the deep house stuff.
And just, like, on your own, that's what you would put, that on to, like, you know, clean the house or whatever.
Yeah, I actually have a driving job, a drive, and listen to it all day long.
Do you stop at red lights and just start fucking going nuts in your car? You're just like, oh, the beat's dropping at a red light!
I'm on drugs!
No, I'm a cool laid-back dude, but the funny thing is I actually am a DJ, and I usually DJ a lot of EDM and a lot of, like,
okay. See?
Stuff,
so. It's always coming
there's
up that there's always a
you're
tie.
Connected. You're connected.
You're connected. You're in the world because you're an EDM DJ. I'm saying, like, I'm looking for straight, just a guy that works at Enterprise that fucking blares it on his way home.
You're getting your dick sucked by a girl wearing fucking ladybug wings.
Yeah.
Of course you like the music. I'd like the music, too, if it was fucking was just getting gashed like that constantly from it. Lou's fucking more of a women after they do the chicken dance.
Yeah.
Lou's like, hey, fat chicks, get those queefs out in the chicken during the chicken dance.
He goes, hey, everybody, one more song, and then the open bar turns into cash bar.
Now everybody, let's do the bird dance.
And then you walk over to the cash bar and just play center field.
Lou, did you ever get sucked off at a wedding?
No.
You're such a liar.
I try, but I strike out a lot.
You
but,
try a lot? Do you always put it out there in the microphone? Oh.
The fact that your DJ wedding slacks are getting super tight. Looking at the bridal party.
Hey, Jay, I got one for you if you like that Chainsmoker song. Try Tritonal Blackout.
Tritonal?
Yeah.
If you make, blackout. I will check it out.
Will, you might turn Jay into an EDM fan.
There's a couple of... Listen, I like that...
That'll leave me alone.
The Calvin Harris song with Florence from Florence and the Machines. Great. Love it. Yeah, I like that Chainsmokers song.
I'm already losing Jay.
You weirdly are losing me. I realize now that I like more than I thought I did.
Jay, and you do have, and I'm just going to say this, your hair is metal and EDM DJ.
Yeah, it is true. And I wear knuckle gloves.
I mean, you could easily
Christine,
go
you're about to get traded in for an 18-year-old glitter tit.
Glitter tit. Christine's like, yeah, that, she's the producer of our new Huey. Yeah. This girl, she goes, I'm sorry, I was watching a Steve Aoki interview.
My new girlfriend just perched up in the corner, all like sitting on like the top of the couch, and she goes, I don't like,
Christine doesn't like me, I think.
Christine's got to write her contract out, and then you'll be her producer.
I understand. She's, then I'll bring you in as a producer afterwards, because you promise, because I have some big ideas what to do with this place.
I want to do a whole theme for a year,
and do suds in here. So this is EDM?
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
They all look like they're in Final Fantasy.
I think this is actually computers, looks like.
No.
I can't call it.
Will, so this is EDM. So there is singing. So is it old house music I'm thinking of?
I think we lost Will.
Oh, we lost Will. Jacob
hangs up on him.
Swings a hammer.
Yeah. He has a...
Oh, here, all right.
He has call time limits. He gives us 3 minutes for whites, 2 minutes for blacks.
He goes, you're up. Call me 1-800-COLLECT, because you're done.
Let's take our first break, and we'll come back.
I don't know if I like this. I don't think I do.
I don't like this one. But I like a few of them, though.
Hold on. Let the beat drop. Oh, no, no, no. God damn, I thought it was going to drop right there. Airwaves on the wire. They all sound the same when they sing.
Sort of.
Born
yes.
Into dawn. Booyah, yeah, booyah, yeah, booyah, yeah. Falling and falling and
I know what? I like it, but I can't take my first love. Mexican doo-wop.
They're gone! Just like that!
I'll be there to comfort you.
Oh.
Build my world and dream around
oh.
you. Hey, everybody. Eat the bonfire.
Hey, y'alls! Ring's mission is to make neighborhoods safer. Today, over 1 million people use the amazing Ring video doorbell to help protect their homes. Ring knows home security begins the front door, but it doesn't end there, so now they're extending that same level of security to the rest of your home with the Ring Floodlight Cam. Just like Ring's amazing doorbell, Floodlight Cam is a motion-activated camera and floodlight that connects right to your phone with HD video and two-way audio that lets you know the moment anyone steps on your property. See and speak to visitors. Even set off an alarm right in your phone. With Ring's Floodlight Cam, when things go bump in the night, you'll immediately know what it is. Whether you're home or away, the Ring Floodlight Cam lets you keep an eye on your home from anywhere. Ring Floodlight offers the ultimate home security with high-visibility floodlights and a powerful HD camera that puts security right in your hands. With Ring, you're always home. Save up to $150 now off a Ring security kit when you go to ring.com/comedy. That's ring.com/comedy. Again? Again, you ask? ring.com/comedy.
How old were you when you got into EDM?
Now. It's been a year, so I'm 30.
You're fresh in.
Yes.
Are you still, but you're a club person? You go to clubs?
No, not at all. I am old for that, I guess.
I feel like you worked really hard. Are you trying to recapture something because you worked very hard?
True, to be a professor by 29 professor is impressive.
By 29, yeah. And then now you're like, well, now I got to get it out there, and the guys you want to, you know, do things with that have abs are usually at some of these weird, queefy gay parties.
No, it's like a weird media-induced nostalgia. I'm Mexican, so I grew up with, like, super, you know, Cholo upbringing and black culture, too. So those were the clubs I went to. And as an adult, I just heard EDM and liked it and felt like, oh, I missed out on this kind of white way of growing up with, you know, raves and all that.
Okay. Well, I don't know if, yeah. I mean, it's definitely a white way to grow up. But I don't know how many white people, like, I don't think I was really exposed. I was exposed to it so little that it always remained fringe and kind of weird to me. Like, kids that were just taking ecstasy and clubbing.
Hey, I'm going to get you up hot in the pants, but right across the window from us is Cuatro del Amore, the ultimate Mexican a cappella group.
Or the replacement for the Chapo cartel. It's one of the two.
It's one of those two things. Either way, they have voices of angels.
But you were saying...
Take me back like a fool. Do, 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 do.
So you got into it just as an adult. How did you... Was it the radio? Did a friend...
Well, I was listening to Marilyn Manson videos. I had them minimized, yes. And I was grading papers.
I love this girl.
Somebody just snuck in some EDM in their Marilyn Manson playlist, and I liked it.
You know what? That's a good buffer point. Because Marilyn Manson, by the way, also, which I'll play when we come back. There's a song. He has a song he did with Sneaker Pimps, which is sort of EDM.
And I'll tell you this: it makes a lot of sense on why I'm losing you so quickly to it.
Well, because this college professor that I have a big crush on, Catherine, from undisclosed part of California.
It's so funny that she's just grading these Ivy League papers where they're like, well, obviously the syntax is not representative. Like, the beautiful people, the beautiful people.
That's exactly how it goes.
That's awesome. And her, Marilyn Manson, as your professor, did you read my thesis? You didn't like it?
Any notes? I should spell check it next time.
All right. I mean, it's starting to make sense because the Marilyn Manson, Christine right here, up here has corn with Skrillex.
Well, that's why I figured we would play these little EDM mashup things on our comeback.
But I see why I'm losing you. I think, Jay, you're EDM.
I think I'm totally EDM.
And think about how much you're fascinated with glitter tits. You just keep bringing it up. I like boats and crystal clear water on islands.
And wearing an 18-year-old like a hat? I am interested in all of those things.
Is this, I mean, your clothing style, if we brightened it, could transition pretty quickly.
You think I dress EDM?
No, but we could make you EDM with a slight adjustment.
Oh, maybe some rainbow knee socks?
Yes. Yes.
Into my Jordans?
Closer, warmer.
Okay, like
you already have orange Jordans.
I also have, I don't wear them out. But I've got about 2,000 unopened candy necklaces in the house. So, great news, everybody. I'm going to finally get to whip those out.
Lewis is going to be like, hey, why does Jay have a pacifier all the time?
Why is Jay's neck always blue, red, and purple, and yellow?
Yeah, when he sweats in the summer, it's gross, but it smells sweet.
All right, Catherine, are you single?
Yes, I am.
I like this girl a lot. Why? Because you worked hard on your studies.
I like you, Jay. You're fantastic.
Goddamn right.
I think we're Christine Baggett. We found an EDM girl.
I may have found my EDM girl. And she's a year younger than you. 2 years younger than you.
All right. Now you're just, that was just twisting the knife.
He goes, she's younger than you. She's more educated.
She's not 18.
She's not 18, though. True. You want a glitter tip.
Girl fight.
That's my sell-by.
Yeah. Well, thanks for calling
in. If we ever see you in person, Catherine, you can kick Christine's ass. Because you could come claim with yours.
So I guess that blows my theory. She
EDM
likes
dance
it.
Off.
She's a fucking Ivy League professor.
Yeah, she's a girl, so I'm not taking it in the full account. I think it's music for girls who like to dance.
Okay.
And Catherine strikes me as a dancer. If I know her like I think I do, she strikes me as a dancer.
You know your cat like you think you do?
If I know my kitty cat?
all right, well, we'll keep seeing if there's regular, just, I'm just very interested by it. Well, I do too like it. But we have a new member.
Yes.
Of the Bonfire.
Yes.
Since Merkface Andy now on the Nick DiPaolo show on, what is that? Talk Faction?
Faction Talk.
Faction Talk. So you should
Radio.
You can listen to it from 8 to 9 p.m.
I hear it's the weakest signal on off Sirius XM.
Yeah. It's on right now, but then they go till 9 p.m., right?
I heard that Faction actually has the softest signal in Sirius XM.
Yeah, I actually heard if you listen to Faction.
Like if you're near an underpass.
Yeah.
It's a wrap.
I also heard that the proceeds from that channel go to fund I don't want to say this wrong, Boko Haram?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Where ours, the money from Comedy Central Radio clearly goes to freedom fighters.
Absolutely. We arm the weak.
Yeah, we arm the weak. We defend the defenseless. Newest member, we have one Lou, so why don't we just double on down and get a new Lou?
Lou 2.
Lou 2.
Black Lou, Lou 2. It's in the air. We're not sure what we're going to do.
Yeah.
Now, I got to stay out of the gates. I have a problem because we've become a family here at the Bonfire, Lou. And welcome, Lou.
Thank you.
Now, would you prefer Louis or Lou?
I prefer whatever you want to say.
All right, Lou. A.K.A. Black Lou, A.K.A. New Lou, A.K.A. Black Ops.
My plan?
That's what Merkface Andy
Black
said.
Ops is a good one, but my plan?
Merkface Andy gets credit for that.
To keep things completely on the up and up, because you're like, well, isn't it just shitty to call Black Lou, Black Lou?
Yes.
And I'm like, that is shitty. So now I think we should also call Lou, White Lou.
Can we call him Cracker Lou?
Cracker Lou?
Cracker Lou and Black Lou?
That.
Yeah, why not?
Oh, someone's about to reinvigorate their whole DJ career. We just played all this new music for you.
Yeah, now you got EDM, now you got a new name.
Now here's an issue. And this isn't, I want to say it's a small issue, but I don't know how small of an issue it's going to be. There's a lot going on here, there's a lot of dude, a lot of testosterone. And yes, Lou, Black Lou, you probably have the biggest dick. But, Let's take that out of it. What there is in the testosterone world here is a lot of sports people. I think Jacob likes some kind of a foreign archery league.
He's like, I'm more into cricket.
I prefer
badminton.
Lou's a big Mets guy, yeah, or whatever Eddie Vedder says is cool.
Lou looks like if Mr. Met, if Mr. Met were a person.
Lou's the giant baseball head. Dan is Nuggets. He's a little all over the place because his dad was a Rolling Stone.
Yeah.
Gathered no moss, though.
Yeah,
but did gather a pretty wicked liver disease.
But where you're headed with this, is we're in the same territory with what you're talking about.
But I'm me more so.
Well, you're more consistent.
No, but this is, I'm Eagles, Sixers, hardcore, and we got, right away, walks in. It's a bad first impression of wearing this Cowboys hat.
He's wearing a Cowboy, yeah.
It's been driving me bonkers for the past 5 minutes.
I'm disappointed that you led with Nuggets because that's my third favorite team. I'm a Niners, Giants, then Nuggets. I'm not even that big of a Nuggets fan.
Oh, baseball.
I just like the Nuggets in the NBA. 49ers, though. And that's what I'm saying. That's a problem. The Cowboys hat rubs us both the wrong way.
Yeah, but more, I mean, this is straight up divisional rivalry.
Well, also the early 90s for the Niners Cowboys was a big thing when I was growing up. So I'm saying, like, had it been the New York Giants, had it been, I mean, the Redskins, I'd be like, yeah.
No, Skins I have a beef with, too.
But I'm saying Skins you have a beef with, that would have made more sense. I'm saying as a Niners fan, I wouldn't have given a shit about the Redskins.
Oh, for you, you're saying, so now it's two.
He's doubled down.
Two violations.
Two violations. That's what I'm saying, as a Niner fan and an Eagles fan.
Now, I'm sure this is something we can all solve over some hot trance dance house techno.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure some EDM could probably. But you're a diehard Cowboys fan.
Big time.
And we were talking about that back when the Niners were good. And
where are you from, Dallas?
No, I'm from Jersey.
Come on, Black Lou. Why are you a Cowboys fan? Same reason Keith Robinson, like a lady, because they have pretty uniforms?
Nah.
What made you get in?
The first time I ever started watching football, Emmitt Smith was on TV. That's all it was.
And he just got you.
He just got me. The excitement, the hype.
He was cool looking.
Yeah. Weren't a big Tiki Barber guy, I guess, or?
No, not at all.
Do you have family that likes the Giants and you wanted to stick it to them by being a Cowboys fan?
The majority of my family likes the Cowboys, but we do have some fans that are Giants fans.
Cause Michael Che became a Niner fan cause his older brother was a Giants fan. And the Niners and the Giants had a rivalry, so he knew if he picked the Niners, it'd piss his brother off.
And he's still a Niners fan?
Diehard, yeah, to the day.
Che?
Yeah, Michael Che's a big Niner fan.
That's so hilarious.
And he's from the Lower East Side.
That's really, really hilarious. Wait, why would other people in your family be Cowboys fans too?
Older.
Was it a family? Athletes. Was it a family reunion day that Emma Smith came on that TV?
No.
Okay, like, hold on. We're not big sports people here, but
who is that Emma Smith? Stays low, runs strong.
And can I follow his team? every time. Oh, it's great to hear.
Oh yeah, getting tweeted at by Garth, who says every time Jay says 18-year-old glitter tits, an angel gets its wings, which is true.
Black Lou, you into EDM music at all?
A little bit.
Are you?
Not too crazy, but.
Are you also into 18-year-old glitter tits?
I mean, if they're around.
Yes.
Yeah.
Jay, isn't that some of the point?
Yeah. I'm learning a lot about Jay's love of glitter tits today.
I just like looking at them, man. Now, if you have a girl who has glitter on her tits, she's probably also got like a pussy lip hanging out or something is what I've come to notice.
That they're just a mess? Like those girls at Bonnaroo?
No, she's doing
around
something to purposefully have her pussy hanging out. How old are you, Black Lou?
32.
32?
So the same age. So he became a Cowboy fan when the Niners-Cowboys rivalry meant something.
Yeah, we'll fix it. We'll get you back
on track.
Well,
I'll tell you this. It's fine right now, but it's going to get weird around September, October.
It's going to get weird, especially if, Dak Prescott. Man, I want him to be bad so much.
Well, the Niners were 2-14, so I'll just be probably.
Who's your team, Jacob?
Football team.
Yeah. Giants?
I guess this is Giants.
You don't really
weak
care,
football.
Though.
No, not really.
You're more of like, you like to watch marathons and shit.
No, I watch NASCAR.
Was it NASCAR?
Yeah.
Wait, Jacob's Wayne in NASCAR.
Paintball before that?
No, I'm a Mets fan.
Oh, I thought you said paintball and NASCAR. No. Do you watch professional paintballing?
Do you guys awkwardly talk Mets when you go hang out together?
We do.
You're like so...
Awkwardly? Yeah.
He goes, so what do you think?
You and Jacob are good after work friends now, though, Lou.
Well, yeah. We've always been cool. Now that we got Andy out of the way, it's a lot better.
Right? Yeah. Is it just me, or, I mean, there's like, you guys are really getting along better.
Have you guys become more family over the past 2 years doing the show?
Yeah, sure. We would never talk if we didn't have this show.
And now you guys are buddies. You hang out. I was trying to let you know, Black Lou, you're coming into a family here. Lou, so you have to forsake all else.
Sounds good.
Lou, you're not involved in race wars anymore?
No, no, no. Not okay. Since I left Sirius, unfortunately.
What are the shows you're involved in? Because I'll let you know, while Lou looks like, he's our straight, like he's our straight-up dude, Lou's finger-fucking the Pete Corielli and Sebastian show a little on the side. And then he just fucks us while he smells his fingers.
And we do need, Jay brings up a very interesting point. We do need to know who your side shows are.
I only have one.
Who's your side show?
Opie.
Okay. We get that. And you started there?
Yes.
So we're kind of your side show in that.
Opie?
But here's the thing.
Still doing radio. No, I'm kidding. I'm still doing radio. And, I mean, that's a lot of years.
But you could, we can get, we're no longer in his broom closet.
That's true. And you could already say, and you could say on microphone, it's fine. We don't even have much crossover audience. You could say this is already clearly the better show. Your eyes are saying yes. Your mouth is telling me no,
but your eyes telling me yes.
You know what's funny? I thought he was going to just laugh at that, but he made such a weird face that it made me think, I'm like, are we better already? I'm going to start believing my own bullshit. I'm going to walk around these halls with my dick out.
I'm going to be like this, Jay.
What's up, serious?
I'm going to be like, Jay, you are causing conflicts at work.
I'm like, tell Opie to get me a cup of coffee. Yeah. I'm like, that is going to be awkward as hell.
You told Howard Stern to suck your dick?
Did you tell Howard Stern to suck your dick?
Jay.
You're not supposed to look at him.
Yeah. You not only
did you send Jason Ellis an envelope full of cum?
Yeah. Did you say high heat that you're going to show him high heat?
So we're going to... Oh, all right. I mean, you're going to want to hear this guy, Dan.
Do tell.
Vincent in Tennessee says he is a trucker who loves... well, it's supposed to be EDM. Jacob wrote EMD. He just wants you to know how straight he is. He doesn't even care how...
He goes, what's this called? I don't even know what this is called.
This whole thing's stupid anyway.
Yeah, that's fucking goofy flutes. I don't give a shit.
Vincent, you there, my friend?
Yes, sir.
Hey, buddy. And your accent is absolutely perfect. I would have never guessed EDM was your thing. You there?
Yeah.
Very cool. And
he's just all fired up. He's just tucking his lip in as he walks around his truck. He goes, yeah, no, I'm here. Yeah, no, I'm here.
He goes, I'm crashing pretty hard, man. Banged out a rip through a thing full of Molly last night. Went nuts on the lot lizards.
Yeah, it turns out they like the Molly just as much as I do.
You're an 18-wheeler trucker, yeah?
Yes, sir.
And you drive around the truck and listen to EDM?
Yeah, I pretty much switch it back and forth between Comedy Central and BPM all day.
Man, we're finding out our crossover is way more. It's way more than OP Radio.
That is
it's
two speeds.
More EDM. We have just like people like us. And I trash.
Can we already
EDM.
Fire Black Lou and just get some girl in here who's got like green hair or something?
Some Japanese girl that doesn't even know how to work the phones, but she just dances.
I don't know.
Yeah,
it'll be so adorable though.
I go, guys,
so we let her stay.
Guys, it might just be me, but I think Jay's hitting on the new phone screener real hard.
Sup? I know it's a turtleneck, but any glitter happening on the things, what's up?
Christine, fellas, I'll meet you guys downstairs for a smoke. I just want to sit here and talk to Tanasha. Tanaki, I was going to say Tanaki. I don't know.
I thought you were somewhere with... I thought we were going to make her black and call her Tanisha.
No.
And then you went Tanasha.
I don't know.
Which does make it sort of Asian.
It does, see? It feels Asian.
You may be having a stroke. Let's take our second break.
Why? Is it because my smile's drooping?
No, you're fine. No, put both hands up. No, both hands.
This member stroke.
No, put up both hands.
Stroke Elliot.
That's still just one. Can you tell?
No, both
hands. Okay.
Right. Sometimes it's a man.
I'm gonna go mouth to mouth this queef. We'll be right back, everybody. It's the Bonfire featuring Black Lou.
And now back to the Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It's more Marilyn Manson than it is EDM.
Great. That's fair enough.
It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J Oakerson. The new crew put together. Merkface gone. Lou 2, a.k.a. Black Lou, a.k.a. Black Ops, a.k.a. the Cowboys fan who will not wear his stuff if they play either one of our teams. Well,
oh, he might.
Oh, he's tatted up.
Oh shit.
Oh, Lou,
I fucking told you, Christina, she'd get an Eagles tattoo. You said I'd regret it.
Lou 2's got a tattoo, and Jay doesn't. Lou 2 with the star on the arm.
Got to, man.
Lou 1, do you have a Mets tattoo?
No, I don't do tattoos. I'm too pale.
We could do it. That means you can do some deep color, though.
Yeah,
I bet a mosquito bite, I get a scar for like 3 years. There's no way I could do a tattoo.
I bet Mets blue and orange would look great on some nice pale loose skin. Blue one skin?
I'd go to the hospital and never come out.
From a tattoo?
Yeah.
Black Lou, let's bet on a game. Eagles Cowboys this year. I'll put $1,000 on the Eagles, and if you lose, you have to get an Eagles tattoo on your other arm.
Oh.
I can never do that.
I respect that. That was your first prison test. Okay. Now I'm going to offer you a cigarette and then try to fuck you.
Yeah. You go, Black Lou, you like Dan? He goes, what? You like Dan? He's yours now. I go, Jay, did you just give me the Lou, our new screen card?
Isn't the prison rules where you give a bunch of cigarettes? No, man, just take the cigarette. That's totally cool. And then you come knocking a few months later. You're like, hey, man, I'm a little horny, man. Why don't you suck my dick? And it's like, nah, man, I'm not going to play that shit. And you're like, I mean, I gave you all those cigarettes. I feel like you owe me something for those cigarettes.
I'd be like, you know what? You tricked me. Drop them.
You know what?
The good sport.
I realize when I've been had.
The good sport prisoner.
Yeah.
Guy goes, you know what? That is solid logic.
My friend, you have bested me.
Yeah.
I'll suck your dick.
Get it hard. Oh, you're going to make me get it hard. You are a stickler. Big J Oakerson is going to be, where is it? Lou won, that is. Big J Oakerson is going to be at the Denver Comedy Works this Friday and Saturday and Sunday. Friday through Sunday. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
May 19th through May
21st.
It's
going to be a rough Monday back at the Bonfire.
Oh, boy. Tickets at BigJComedy.com. Make sure you go check them out, Denver. Fantastic club.
I'm so excited for it, man. I've never been. It's my first time at the club ever. I heard downtown Denver Comedy Works is insane.
Have you ever been to Denver before?
Yeah.
Okay.
I did the improv once, and I like Denver a lot. Christine's actually coming with me on this one. She's excited. She's never seen Denver. And
you guys will have a blast.
Yeah, I'm excited. And Fenoya is actually working there with me, too. And of course, Dan Soder. Going to be at the old Laugh It Up in Poughkeepsie, New York. And guess what, Poughkeepsie? That's one night only. So get your behinds out there. That one night, Saturday, May 27th. You can always get your tickets right there, easy peasy, at dansoder.com. Get your tickets fast, they're going to sell out, because
today in Midtown Manhattan, I was just reading this, and this just in, a horsey was hurt. No, but I was hanging out in the studio with Lou, and then I saw that there was a runaway horse hit by a car in Midtown Manhattan. It was actually hit by a taxi.
So, whose fault is that?
I don't know. That's what I mean. The horse, obviously, because the horse is an animal and doesn't understand traffic rules.
He didn't know where the secret tunnel back to the Shire was. Why is there a free horse running around in New York City?
That's the whole thing. The New York Post isn't saying
Bronx Zoo
where it's from. It's saying that there's a stable nearby that's used for horse and carriages.
They said it's not a carriage horse. I think you can actually rent horses to go horseback riding in the park. It may have been one of those, but they're saying they didn't know where they came from. But this one was saddled, and there was a white horse going down 58th that was also saddled and loose.
Daniel to Jamba Juice.
Yeah, get it up. And I go, whoa, hello, Missy. Hit on a girl and a horse. I see you're going into that soul cycle. Might I give you a lift?
This subway's taking too long. Let's just horse it across the bridge. Yeah,
I got it. What time's my spot? 10:15? I can get it. Slap its ass.
I was like leaping off on the fucking Hiafra where you go. He goes, oh, man. He goes, can I take a picture? He goes, oh, dude, I would love to take a picture. Goes, I just got to run. I'm going to be late for another spot. He goes, I have to go all the way across town down to the cellar. Yeah!
That would be cool just to show up to your spots and a horse.
Oh, dude.
Where you go, hold on. Coming up. Here you go. Whoa. I go, hey, Adele, who's on right now? And I'm just saddling up to the tree outside the stand.
Attaboy.
Oh,
you get in the parallel park with him?
Yeah, watch out.
Okay. All right. Hang on. Cut it. Cut the wheel now. Cut the wheel. You got it. You're good. Cut the wheel.
Hey, guys.
Cut the wheel. Trust me. I'm seeing it. Cut the wheel.
Is the show running on time? Okay. He is angry. Adele, you guys got any tickets? You guys got any carrots back there I can give this guy?
He's like, can you get Judah Freelander to go inside? He's spooking the horse.
Yeah.
He's spooking the horse.
Judah, don't touch him. Judah, don't touch him. You got to tell other cops. You know that thing where you tell other people not to do something and you look like a dickhead? I go. Louis C.K.'s out front. I go, Louis, can you not touch him? Louis. Don't touch him.
Louis, he's new. I'm still trying to break him. Louis.
Hold on.
Louis, are you
he's nervous.
I'm going to park him around the corner.
It's just weird that they don't know where the horse is from, that the horses just appear in Manhattan. And it was saddled, which, by the way, that would have been a badass move if it's coming down 8th Avenue and you just grab the saddle and jump on it. Yeah. They go, oh, my God, thinking, look at this horse. You go, hey, can you hold this backpack real quick?
I was
hold
thinking on. Even better.
Yeah! Just get on it as it goes by. You just put your foot in perfectly.
Or while they were stopping, and goes, whose horse is it? What is it? And all of a sudden, like an actual, like, Native American Indian, yeah, like, jumps on with, like, a hatchet and a bow and arrow.
Sorry, I was over at Uniqlo looking at jackets.
Like, no saddle? Yeah. Just jumps on the horse rawback? Is that what they call it? Probably not.
I came on my horse. I always wanted to see New York. It's from Oklahoma. He's all the way over. Yeah, that's, I mean, it's so much fun to watch New Yorkers when, like, a deer gets loose or a horse. Because, like, people in the middle of the country are just like, oh, that horse is loose. But here they're like, hey, look at this horse. This horse ain't supposed to be here right now.
Oh, one got drilled.
Whoa,
shit. Is that the one that was standing up after that?
Yeah. So, okay, horse isn't dead.
No.
Okay, at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter and Instagram, there's a picture of a cab with a horse laid out.
I thought if a horse could go down.
I had the light! The horse come out of nowhere!
You saw it! It was not my fault!
Yeah. Dude, if you're in the back of that cab, you go, ah, fuck!
Did you hit that horse?
Hey, horse. Hey, John Schechter from Schechter and Schechter. Do you feel like you
were... Do you have neck pain? What's hurting?
Are you having nightmares?
Are either one of your hoods numb? Let me know what they are. Hello. Greenberg. And
John Schechter from Schechter Solomon, Schechter and Schechter.
You got a legitimate case, my friend. I have a falafel cart guy that says he saw that cat.
I have, on very good word, that none of this was your fault.
You are a horse, correct? Yes and no. You say yay and nay. Now, I think the case we're building, clearly, there's some Instagram proof. There's a picture of the cab. You're a runner. That's how you pay for your, that's your livelihood, is running.
I like then cutting to a war room like a few good men, yeah, where Schechter and Schechter and Schechter are all there. So he goes, I don't know. He goes, if we lose, she's chickening out. Our number one witness. She's chickening out.
I'll tell you this right now.
She doesn't want to be in the papers.
The cab union will come down on us something fierce. We do not have a case. I do not want to go against them in the courtroom if we do not have this witness.
I like the behind the scenes of Mari Povich commercial lawyers. It's like they're really in the middle. Like, man, I tell you what, I'm burning the midnight oil here, but I'm going to get this horse what he deserves.
This horse is a majestic beast. They say they're one step away from unicorns.
I'm terrified of horses.
Are you really?
Terrified.
You have horse phobia?
I got on a horse one time with my ex-girlfriend.
How old were you?
I was...
There's nothing better than a dude trying to get pussy and getting spooked by a horse.
No, I wasn't trying to get pussy. I was already fucking her for years at that point. Okay. It was, we were just a couple, and she was a horse rider. She did it. And I never thought to do it with her. And she was like, one time, she said, would you do it with me? Would you get on a horse with me? I was like... Sure.
You go, yeah, whatever. Whatever. They're just like fast dogs.
When I first put my foot in the stirrup,
yeah,
it started moving.
Oh yeah.
And I was like, oh god, it hates me. It thinks I'm too big.
Yeah.
It doesn't know how to tell me. It doesn't know how to tell me I'm too big. It's just trying to walk off. And they go, no, it's fine. They always just gonna throw your other leg over. I go, it doesn't like me already. I don't want to do it. And I was just like,
were you doing the one foot as it walks away?
Yes.
I know that.
I was like stiff legged the whole time. Just go like,
okay.
And it's like, he's like, don't be scared. It goes,
Jake.
And my girlfriend, I don't know if she was fucking with me or not, but she'd be like, don't be scared, it's going to start running. I go, I don't want it to run at all. I want to get off.
There's nothing better than someone trying to keep their cool. I mean, when I went to summer...
Well, Jacob's the fucking Marlboro man, so I didn't know, we didn't know that. We're learning all this now about his NASCAR love.
Jacob goes, actually, it's funny. A horse, you just got to stare at him in his eyes long enough. Then you can break him.
Do you trust me? Give me your hoof.
Give me... Look at... Hey, buddy. I'm your friend.
I went... When I was at summer camp, when I was like 9, we did horseback riding, and the horse tried to get me off by going backwards and putting its head down like
that.
And I held on. I was like, oh, no, 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 no.
You were yanking back?
No, like he went flat. Like he tried to put his head against the ground to like try to like throw me off. Not go backwards.
I saw the word. I said the word whoa so many times.
Whoa. Terrifying. So if we rented one of these horses, you wouldn't ride it. We can't do a day of you riding horses in the park.
I mean, dude, I would do it, but I'd say there's a 90% chance I get injured.
Now why?
I'm so afraid. I'm one of those things, like, I'll jump off it while it's moving because I'm afraid of what's about to happen, so I'm just going to take I'll do that thing where I make the risk move.
Have you ever been skiing?
Yeah, got hurt.
Yeah, because you started going too fast and you freaked out and jumped, didn't you?
I thought I was doing good. No, I thought I was doing good.
Mm-hmm.
And what I was doing so good was I learned how to get in other people's ski tracks. And if you cannot be afraid of that, you'll fly. You go fast and you can control it because you're sort of right there. You know what I mean? Like, if I just turn a little bit, like, you get what I'm saying, right?
Yeah.
And then I realized that I was in two people's different ski tracks who went very opposite ways. And my legs opened up real wide and I clunked. Somehow I went down, still face forward, clunked my head on the ground. It was, and everyone was looking and people were pointing and laughing from the chairlift. Yeah, it was. And I was like, I went inside and drank hot cocoa by the fire the rest of the day. It was a school trip that I fucking desperately tried to beat chicken pox to get to. I remember how important that trip was for me to go on.
And then you got injured.
I hated it. Didn't get injured. Injured's the wrong word. I got embarrassed instead. Then I killed the whole family. I told you a story, right, where I nailed the whole family on my skis, and then they ripped my lift ticket, and they chased me on a ski mobile. It was a whole thing.
You've never told us that story.
No.
You hit an entire family on skis?
In my defense, they were, like, teaching a little kid to ski. It was like a grandfather, a mom, and the mom's son.
Deb looking smoking hot.
Yeah, let me take a peek.
She's got the shirt on. Hey, she caught us looking.
She saw us all looking.
Oh, boy.
Man, we all just looked really creepy.
Yeah. I felt more comfortable with the cartel in there.
Black Lou, you want to introduce yourself to Deb? I'd say stand over there and just slap your dong on the window.
Yeah.
And we'll let him know. It's like, oh, yeah, we got Black Lou now.
She just starts golf clapping.
Yeah, we should fill you in on some of the... Because Lou's not familiar with any...
Yeah, Lou, it's like learning a language. You'll learn it just by being submerged in it. But we have a thing with the Golf Channel where Deb Doninger is, we think, the hottest thing, you know, at Sirius.
Okay. Well, she's Jacob's dream woman.
Yeah.
I mean, he
hears Dreamweaver every time she walks into the studio. And then her co-host, Ben, loves orange, which I'm sure you can tell from just looking over there.
Yeah, and just to fill in on everybody here, Lou... got a $300 throw blanket that he uses to put out cigarettes and jerk off onto.
Jacob
can dance.
Fold his bones and can do a kip up.
Jacob can do a kip up from on the ground, spring up to his feet.
And Jay and I cannot. All right, so please tell the story of you crashing.
I came down the mountain.
Okay.
Okay. Wow.
You might want to pull that off the TV, considering she can see us looking at it.
I was coming down I went on a more expert hill.
So there's blue, green, black.
Don't remember.
Okay.
Maybe green.
Blue, it's like blue trails are the beginner.
Whatever
the green,
it was, there was going to be some trees in this one.
Black. Okay, maybe
and there was
green.
Two trees off to the side.
Yeah.
That in between those two trees... this little boy was being pushed between his mother and his grandfather. What it appeared to be.
Okay.
But I don't always see those two people, and like someone, and I came down, and I can't control myself, and I'm screaming, "Get out of the way!"
But at that moment, before they can hear you, it's just a mother and her father. It's just a lady with her dad and her son, and she goes, "This is one of the nicest moments we've ever had."
Yeah, absolutely.
We're teaching Michael to ski, and then Dad, I'm just so glad that you got back from Vietnam and you're safe. And, you know, you and Mom went through a lot, but look, I met Jake and we had Michael, and here you are teaching your grandson how to ski. And then just in the background.
Yeah, meanwhile, just like a fucking meteor of like a fat guy out of control.
Just some metal. Just
I mean, coming in fucking hot.
Yeah. And at this point, do you know you're already out of control?
Yeah.
So by the time you see the family, you're like, I'm going too fast.
I'm
going
to kill this family. And I'm screaming, get out of the way. And they're almost giving like the...
they're like...
go around us.
Oh, that guy's scared.
Because they were sort of off the path. It was, but I was just, for some reason, that's where the path I caught. And I was coming in
fucking hot.
I mean, the fence is probably one of their faults. I probably caught one of their paths. And they go brace because they don't want the kid to get hit, and I just drill them all like bowling pins. And then I get up.
So you start coming down the
fuck your grandpa!
Move! 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 Get out of the way! Get out of the way! So then they just go over and you just fucking wipe them out.
Drill them, get up, ski's still on.
One ski.
No, my ski's still on.
Both skis?
I get up and then I just fucking say nothing and just continue going. I just try to escape. And then I realize, like, a little bit down, it was like a trail. As I get further down the trail, now I'm being chased by a ski mobile. They stop me and they rip my lift ticket in half so you can't take the lift anymore.
So you wrecked these people. How old were you?
14 or 15.
You just blasted this family.
Wailed them.
But that's better than you being a full-grown adult and doing it. 14, 15, I think is a little more acceptable. Because you're just like, you're just a teenager.
The whole damn idiot. I was such, like, again, like, white garbage growing up. I just never, like, didn't, like, everybody else went there in ski suits and shit, and I wore, like, sweatpants, which you guys, once you fall in snow and sweat, and then sweatpants is your main thing. I had sweatpants and probably long johns on, and once those things get wet, it's the worst day of your life.
I've been skiing maybe 5 times in my life. Growing up in Colorado, that's not a lot.
No, that's not a lot, yeah.
It's not a lot for growing up in Colorado. My friends all snowboarded. I never got into snowboarding. In high school, we sleep over at my friend's house. He's like, dude, I'll let you borrow my snowboard. Because him and his brothers all had like a ton of snowboards. So I was like, that's great. I can't wait. So I borrow a snowboard, I go up with them. I wear long johns under jeans.
Oh, Jesus.
And I've never snowboarded before. And,
You're dressed like Shaun White.
Yeah, I look like I'm gonna rip it up at the X Games. I fell so much, that denim was, it's the wettest I've ever felt denim in my life. I'm talking about out of the wash wet.
Yeah.
And I'm freezing, but here's the best part, the last run of the day when I was just going down and they're like, hey, we're gonna leave, so just meet up at my truck. I get caught on a black diamond mogul. So the
on a snowmobile.
So, you know, like,
snowboard.
Snowboard. So I'm just falling forward, getting back up, going down a little, falling forward, and moguls are like, it's like this, it's like up, down, so I'm caught in between them. So I have to like, fight my way to the top and then just fall down, and then I was like, going down the mountain one mogul at a time, like falling into it in jeans.
Really hilarious.
Yeah, it was brutal. I got down to the bottom of the mountain and like took it off like Daniel throws his bike in the Karate Kid. Thing. And I just laid in the back of the truck waiting for my friends who were, by the way, like going off jumps and having the greatest time ever.
Yeah, I'm a bit of a cis puss too on that kind of shit. I really am. Like,
yeah.
Bikes, I would do some pretty risky stuff with.
No.
But I don't know how to ski or snowboard. And my buddy got a snowboard once. My buddy John. You met John.
Yeah.
In the military. And I should have gone down the hill one time. And I was just like, every time I start, I feel any sort of out of control, I just get crazy nervous and I just drop to my knees.
Yeah.
And you get up again, you drop to your knees.
Did you do that as a kid?
The same reason to this day, I cannot put, you've never in my life will or ever see me with 2 feet up on a skateboard. I think it's an impossible action.
So when you watch
skateboarders, I have no idea. When I see a skateboarder just coming down my block, skateboard and putting his foot back up and just going, I'm like, God, but I can't get 2 feet on a skateboard. I don't know how to do it.
What about trampolines?
It doesn't make any sense to me.
Trampolines?
You're not afraid of trampolines, Dan. I'm not a goddamn child.
I don't know. You said you're afraid of skateboards.
Yeah.
But I understand that, but trampoline,
but you can fall off a skateboard. You can't.
Trampoline, you can get out of control. If someone bounces you. You never had that where you go a sideways bounce? Those are terrifying.
I've even done where you've hit the side of the trampoline or hit the springs. It's not the end.
I'm more scared of that.
Trampoline problems to me do not seem like very realistic fears. Skateboard? Falling off a skateboard immediately?
See, skateboard?
Major fear to me.
Skateboard thing to me is, and I've told this story.
I've never roller skated.
What about rollerblade? You never rollerbladed?
Rollerblade? None of the things sounds like it's, if it's anything like ice skating, I get on ice skates, I get terrified, I hold onto the side and I push myself around the thing and I fall once or twice. That said, also what's happening in that time is my feet feel like hard, that bouncing on a slice in the middle of your foot makes no sense to me.
So
rollerblading doesn't make any sense to me. It sounds like it's very uncomfortable to be in them.
This winter, should we do ice skating lessons? Bonfire ice skating lessons? And then try to do a race?
Dan, we're going to start going, coming through with some of the things we say we're going to do.
I know. We really are divorced dads on all of this.
We really make a lot. We really come with divorced dads. And go, you know what, dude? I say we're having a fucking disco dance party here next week.
Yeah,
and then next week, on Sunday, we're going to be like, are we doing a disco dance party? We go, yeah. Seems like a lot of crazy work to put on a disco dance party, to be honest.
4 days a week, and we're wearing all white suits. Like, none of that happened. You go, I know, but it sounded really good.
I know, but how cool would it have been if I learned that new edition dance? I don't think I'm far from it.
I mean,
for the record,
I would like for you to show up and start doing the dance out of nowhere. That would make me pretty goddamn happy. One other thing that I saw in the news that I was talking to is Conan O'Brien's getting sued in court for monologue jokes. He's actually going to the trial over it. They're saying that he did jokes about Caitlyn Jenner, Tom Brady, and the Washington Monument in his monologue on his TBS show, and they're saying that it was taken from a freelancer's social media feed. The plaintiff is Alex Caseberg, who says that he's had 1,000 jokes used by Jay Leno. Here's the weird part.
Wait, what's...
He asserts that the copyrights on 5 of his jokes from December 2014 to June 2015 were infringed by Conan. So this guy took copyright out on his... Like, he copywrote his jokes, which I think...
That he wrote for who?
That he just wrote?
Just in his life. I thought he was saying Jay Leno or something.
No, he wrote... He's credited as having jokes used by Jay Leno.
And so he's credited on that. So he actually...
They're saying he has material... That's what it says in the article.
He has sold jokes to...
Yeah, the article on Hollywood Reporter is saying that who takes credit for more than 1,000 jokes used by Jay Leno and whose material has appeared in publications such as the New York Times and the Washington Post. In California federal court, he asserts that the copyrights on 5 of his jokes from December 2014 to June 2015 were infringed by Conan. So they're saying they're examining the issues surrounding joke creation and weighing a summary judgment. So,
can I tell you what else is going on in this case? If it's anything, I'm just reading everything on the screen here, or is this maybe an advertisement? But is fucking Night Ranger performing? 25-year career in fucking Chicago?
Yeah.
I
think it's 35 years in a night in Chicago.
If they open with Sister Christian, the arena will be empty by the 5th song.
Yeah, do you think they, what else? It's like that old David Spade joke. They're going to open with it, close with it, and play it in the middle.
Oh, yeah, they have to.
Yeah, such a Christian.
Well, I always say that. Christine said Montel Jordan opened and closed with This Is How We Do It, and I'm like, makes sense.
That's also why he's still on tour.
It's exactly what he should have done.
Because he knows what the fans want.
Goddamn right.
Would you ever copyright a joke? That seems really weird to me.
I used to hear things where people like comics would tell me they'd write them down, mail them to themselves. They would if you mail your joke to yourself, it's like a weird like kind of... Like hobo copywriting.
That's so weird. That is real boxcar legal fucking. Yeah, I heard of
it. Like, well, because you get a stamp with the date and the whole thing, and it's like, I don't know how much it really would hold up in any kind of way. But would I ever copyright a joke? No. I don't think so. I've copyrighted like,
So there's
scripts like a script I wrote before.
Well, that makes sense. Like a script or a show idea
but
or any of that.
But your jokes are, yeah, sort of, yeah.
But they're saying that the Conan's legal team was attempted to argue that the jokes in contention used facts and commonly used expressions and were undeserving of extensive protection.
The problem, man, when you start throwing your fucking nuts around in the stolen joke arena, it's always like my joke about Caitlyn Jenner. It's like, you know what no one's ever arguing about is the... someone's story about their interaction or something with Caitlyn Jenner.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying? Like, those aren't things. It's always like, oh, my observation about one of the craziest stories
ever.
The story involves an Olympic hero who decides he's actually a woman, gets his dick cut off, and goes the whole nine, and this guy used to be on the Wheaties box. You know what I mean?
That was what the legal team actually argued. That was verbatim.
That's like the story. So it's like every comedian's jokes, given those facts, like they're going to overlap to some degree.
Yeah.
Unless you tell your story. What doesn't overlap ever is if you go, so I happen to know Caitlyn Jenner, or I saw Caitlyn Jenner and a real thing you're going to tell. Besides that, it's like copywriting, like, oh man, This crowd's so small, we could have done this in my car or something. You know what I mean?
Like other people are doing that?
Yeah, there are. There are indeed, yeah.
Fuck, really?
Or this place is sold out. There's just too many chairs up in this motherfucker. Oh, you know, dude, come on. It's my shit.
Dude, I wrote that about my dad.
I remember years ago two comics getting into an argument about they're both big guys.
Yeah.
And both of them had the joke that it's like, you know, they were like, I was like, I know what you're thinking. What's the bouncer doing up here on stage?
And they had an argument about that?
Yeah, you're just like, dude.
They go, man, I'll tell you right when I was, right where I was sitting when I thought of that, I was in the shower and I was like, I look like a bouncer. And if I was on stage, I'd be like, what's the bouncer doing up here?
You know what I like doing when somebody's opening for me on the road, who I'm talking to, like I own crowd work, when someone would be like, the comic before me will be like, hey, are you guys a married couple? I'm like, oh, here we go, man. Now I got nothing.
Yeah.
He's going to take all my shit.
Why is he doing that? Why is he doing that?
Great, great.
What's he doing?
Hey, man, cool. Glad I brought you on the gig to open for me. Why don't you fucking do all my shit?
Thanks. Do you want to just take my name? Do you want to just go up at the end? You ungrateful asshole.
You asshole.
Everyone knows I ask the questions.
You goddamn ingrate.
I think it's, I'm just too, am I just too lazy of a person? I just think it's weird to copyright your jokes.
It's just like, copywriting your jokes to me seems to be as easy as writing like, you know, original, unique. I don't know. It seems like a little.
Yeah.
Look, listen, I've had overlapping ideas with people before a zillion times. And it's always, but it's always like the joke part of something.
Yeah.
I tend to try, at least, like, before, I don't. I have stuff in my set about, like, tranny stuff, but, like, I don't even touch on the Caitlyn Jenner thing at all, but I do it, but it's like, because I tell a story.
Yeah.
About a real thing that happened.
A thing that happened to you, exactly.
Yeah, so it's like, I don't, like, who's gonna, you know, I mean, I'm not saying anybody else doesn't have a story similar to that, but.
Do you think Sebastian's got, why would you do that? Copywritten? What if you could beat them to the punch? I mean, Get Her Done has to be copyrighted.
Oh, my God. Yeah, he's made a zillion dollars off that. Yeah. That was the fucking, like, the Air Force used it or something as, like, their...
Can you imagine that contract coming through? Like, the Air Force is going to use your catchphrase.
You know? All right. Bye. I'll be over here breaking this soldier's arm. Bye. Like a twig. Can I get a jet? I want a jet. I want a plaid jet.
I want a flannel jet.
I want a flannel jet. A flannel jet. I want to fly it over Nebraska.
Should we?
Randy, get in here. You're my gunman.
I know. I hate that we have to take breaks, but.
Why do we have to take breaks? It's so stupid.
Everything's so dumb.
This is stupid.
Well, it's for our advertisers.
Jay likes EDM, them. And we have to take breaks. This is stupid.
Everything's stupid. Burma Kraken sucks.
I don't like it. Let's just leave.
We'll be right back to say goodbye almost at this point.
Jesus.
This gets away from us, but it is still the bonfire.
True.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Smash! That's Korn and Skrillex. Yeah. EDM mashups.
Yeah,
it's the bonfire. Comedy Central Radio. Sirius XM. Yeah, 95.
That's the sound of Jay going over to the EDM side.
Oh.
Ultimate mashup.
Oh, it's coming. It's coming, dude. Everybody, it's coming. I decided we're also going to make, Black Lou fight, Merkface for who gets the ticket to go to see Corey Feldman live.
Fun. Okay, that's fun.
Yeah. It's the first interracial Mandingo fight.
Jay, you're a barrier breaker.
Yeah. It's not just for black people anymore. We're getting whites involved in Mandingo fighting.
I wanted to talk about this a couple weeks ago, but we haven't got to it, but now we got about 10 minutes to knock this out. But a principal had to resign after making a smash space where teachers could pummel their frustrations with baseball bats. Genius.
Go down. It is sort of genius.
I mean, it's great, dude. He's the, it was Barbara, how do you say her last name? Lees?
Lease? It was actually like Barbara Lies.
Barbara Lies. She's like a badass principal. She goes in with glasses, sunglasses on and a popped collar.
What do you want me to read, Four Eyes? I don't want you to blow this.
You shut your mouth. She's the principal of Kensington Parkwood Elementary School in Montgomery County, Maryland. She said that she got the kids after reading some...
See?
All right.
She got the idea. That's not the word kids, but you saw kids.
I can't see that far.
You have to get new glasses. You look great in glasses.
Thank you. I have to get new glasses. I'm supposed to go very soon. I want to get laser eyes. Robot eyes? Yeah. She, after reading some business articles about
companies creating them for stressed out employees, typically they're called an anger room or a rage room. And then
so that's genius. So you have a room to go smash shit up when you're pissed off.
Especially with kids who are super fucking frustrating.
Yes.
You know, I mean,
that's a great place to break shit up. You should have a room where you can just go fucking ape shit. I would feel much more comfortable with my children's teachers knowing that they had a room just to go fucking ape, just lose their goddamn minds if my kid was being a dick.
Oh.
Wait, hold on. Cut it real quick, though. She goes, okay, great. Well, all right, kids. And remember, your projects are due on Monday, and I'm not going to take any late one. Hey, is the room open? Cool. Let me get a 15-minute sesh. She sparks a cigarette. Yeah, I'm going to go in right now. Shuts the door. Those little motherfuckers!
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? You have asthma, Timmy, do you? Yeah! Oh, we can't have peanuts because it's going to fucking kill Kyle! Kyle, thank your mom for the fucking vegan cupcakes for your birthday.
Oh, no, you're right. Your mom's right. We shouldn't say the Pledge of Allegiance.
You fucking overprivileged cunt!
By the way, can I give you a little, this will be a little fun thing for anybody who's listening today. I'm pretty sure, at Clusterfest.
Yeah.
And Skankfest, I'm going to do that song. Break stuff with Goddamn Comedy Jam.
Which I'm
pretty excited for, but here's, I'm telling you what, and I'm excited to do a Clusterfest.
What's your Fred Durst like?
I don't even know if I'll do it in a Fred Durst voice, but I'll tell you what, Skankfest, it's going to be a full room. You got to come to that. It's going to be a full room mosh pit that I'll turn into. With that crowd, me singing this song, it's going to be insane.
But how's your Fred Durst?
I don't know.
You got to go up and then down and around.
I think you better say.
All right.
I'm going to leave you with a fact.
Yeah, there we go. All right. I just want to get a taste.
Bullshit.
I just want to get a taste of it. Man, Fred Durst was cool.
Yeah. I forgot how great this video is.
It's a great music video. 1999, Fred Durst was very cool. Yeah, Jacob hates him. You never got into it?
Always hated him.
Always hated him. Since the beginning, since he covered George Michael, your sweet George Michael.
Oh, I'm sorry that happened to you. You didn't think it'd be awesome for me to do this at Goddamn Comedy Jam?
No, I can see you doing it.
Can I?
I just can't stand it.
I hate to interrupt. Can I tell you I was legitimately disappointed because I thought you were about to tell me that at Clusterfest and Skankfest there's going to be a smash room?
Oh, wouldn't that be great?
I mean, I want a smash room at Skankfest.
We can just do it.
We should totally have a smash room.
Yeah. A smash room?
Some bats and some stuff people don't want.
Like a TV, and then you got to give them goggles.
No, TV's too much, but some furniture for sure.
But smash room seems like it should be in every fucking office.
It also sounds like it's going to be a place for people to go fuck at the Jersey Shore. You want to be a smash room with Darlene?
Yo, not for nothing. I got to go break a TV and then bust this bitch out.
I'm going to break a couch and her back.
Yeah, dude.
Smash room.
I think Sirius should have a smash room.
Oh, wait.
So, Jacob, when
hang on. Turn this up, because this is the part. Oh, wait. Is that not it?
No.
We missed it?
It's the sounds from Lou. The video's from me.
Oh. Lou ruined everything.
Oh.
Good job, White Lou.
What? I ruined everything by...
Cracker-ass Lou?
Making it not visual for radio? Come on, guys.
Shut up, cracker-ass Lou.
Just because Andy's gone, you don't got to turn on me. I know we all miss him.
We do. You know what? I'm lashing out right now, and I apologize. I'm also lashing out the fact that I forgot Fred Durst was as cool as he was.
That's the most rational conversation a man's ever made wearing a Mets t-shirt under a button-down shirt.
He goes, yo, not for nothing, I was going to smash you with this lug wrench, but
don't misdirect your anger at me. It's me, your old pal Lou. And I was like, he's right.
Oh,
he's right, you know.
All I saw was rage.
You can't take my words seriously with such a stupid outfit on.
Hey, can you make...
I hope we don't treat Black Lou like Jason Newsted, where we have to make him, like, earn our love.
Oh, I wouldn't do that. But Andy didn't die in a bus accident.
That's true.
So.
That's true.
Really, he's more like, who's Rob Trujillo?
You know, people are probably thinking like...
Black Lou's Rob Trujillo.
Yeah. You're not going to make him earn your love?
He has it. We go back.
What do you go back to?
He's been on when he did Opie for a while. Mm-hmm. I've known Lou for a while.
Yeah. So you guys got a whole thing, huh?
Yeah. Why do you think he's in here? It's all set up.
It's all set up.
Yeah, this is a low.
There's no Nick DiPaolo show.
Wait, you think that, you think Sirius would give Nick DiPaolo a show?
No, you think Nick DiPaolo
yeah,
show.
No, Andy's upstate at his grandma's house.
Turn up that YouTube, Lou. Jane Soul. Oh, calm down, Jacob. Calm down. Calm down, Jacob.
Jacob,
calm down.
Jacob's breaking it all.
Jacob, come relax.
Jay, yes, Jacob. You can dress up like Wes Borland when Jay does this show.
Also, we're going to play the orgasm during all this.
Yeah. It's the only way I can come. Ah! I got to break it.
Can you have someone dress up like Wes Borland?
Probably.
Like Lewis?
Lewis would just look like Wes Borland.
Yeah.
He'll get the face paint, like a whole weird... Oh, yeah,
and
absolutely.
The black contacts?
That is Skankfest happening, sold out. Happening at the end of June?
June 24th, June 25th.
That's what it is.
Clusterfest, June 2nd, June 3rd.
You know what's happening way sooner? What? Laugh It Up Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie, New York, is having our friend... Daniel is traveling tonight on a plane. Dan Soder.
Hi.
For one night only. Saturday, May 27th. You get your tickets right now. Don't ruin this. Dan Soder. Well, according to Christine's notes here, you can go to dansoder.deb. Fucking creep.
I don't know why it says that.
But if you actually want tickets, maybe you go over to the new and improved dansoder.com. Get your tickets quickly because we all know.
Oh, yeah. Denver, Colorado. Get ready. Big J. Oakerson going to be at the Comedy Works this Friday through Sunday. That's May 19th through May 21st. Go get tickets at BigJComedy.com. Trust me, you don't want to miss it. One of the best comics working one of the best clubs. So go fucking check that shit out. Also, go check out What's Your Fucking Deal? Season 2 on CISO.com. And follow us on the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
Black Lou, welcome to the family, buddy.
Thank you, guys. Happy to be here.
Take that goddamn hat off. Or you have to kiss Lou on the mouth every time you come in.
Look how close he came, almost kissing me. This is going to work out just fine.
Yeah. All right, guys. Time to go outside and saddle up our horses and get out of here.
Yeah.
So I guess we'll be seeing you guys or talking to you this Wednesday when we talk to you again on the Bonfire.
Yeah!